Okay, and we're back. So let this get this started.
Monkey Argo.
I'm sorry, Mr. Thompson, sir. You asked why it's taking so long to fix. The answer's technical.
Don't apologize. Just try using small words for me.
The cans bust open in the oven because she's set to cook saltuna, which isn't what we've got. Mr. Thompson, I think there's someone here to see you.
Focus, Miss Holcomb. You and I are still talking. Let's start over. Walk me through the process. Show me where it's going awry. Seems we've got a guest. Really now, Parvati, I do wish you'd spoken up. I do apologize. I was given no forewarning of your arrival, or I might have welcomed you at the gates myself. I'm Reed Thompson, Outpost Administrator. I cannot help but notice you are not in uniform. Of course not. I don't have that kind of luck. Seems I allowed my excitement to run away with my wits. Been a few seasons since we've had a visitor pass through.
Only regulator we've got is hooked up to the town transformer. Mr. Thompson ain't liable to be keen on dismantling it.
I beg your pardon. I am most emphatically not keen on any such thing. I can't let you have our power regulator, but I happen to know of another one, and I happen to know exactly how you may retrieve it without frying yourself in the process. Oh yes, saw someone put his hands on a regulator while the power was running. His legs were still twitching when we buried him. There's a power regulator in the old botanical lab. It's mostly abandoned, so all that power is being squandered. Go down to the geothermal plant. Reroute power from the botanical district over to us. Once their power shut down, you can have their regulator and be along on your way. The geothermal plant was built by our owners. Spacer's choice. Lit up the whole Vale once upon a time. Most of the Vale is now abandoned. All that power is going to waste. I was not entirely sure how to tell you this. The botanical labs are not legally inhabited, but there are people who live there. The people living in the botanical labs. They're deserters, former workers. I need them back at their posts. I need them to come home. Good law, no, I don't want you killing anyone, least of all them. My hope is that by cutting off their power, you will convince those deserters to come back to town. Before you go to the plant, I want you to stop by the botanical lab. Speak to their leader, Adelaide. Tell her the power's about to go, and that it's time her band of deserters came back to town. Adelaide's older than the other deserters. She's dignified, kindly. From what I understand, her camp looks to her for leadership. That is not a hypothetical I enjoy entertaining. We need Adelaide back. Nonetheless, I will settle for the return of her followers. We belong to one community, the Spacer's Choice family. If we dissolve into factions, then we will all perish separately. Adelaide will understand that. Of course, I understand completely. Here, let me give you the passcode to the geothermal plant. A sign of good faith for so politely listening to me as I ramble on.
Are you setting off for the Vale? Because I know my way around. I mean, in case you want a guide. I mean, if that's all right with you, Mr. Thompson. Sir.
I hesitate to part ways with Miss Holcomb, but I cannot deny that she is talented and may prove useful to you. Are you sure? I imagine Miss Holcomb will make a reliable companion. She knows her way around the Vale.
Oh, sure. I mean, you got your own business and all, so I'm sure you... Sorry. I'll just be in my garage, fixing stuff. Like I do.
You may find Miss Holcomb at her garage once she and I are done talking. I want you to know I appreciate what you're doing for us, even if you are a stranger. Best of luck to you. Let's start over. Walk me through the process. Show me where it's going awry.
Well, sure. It's, mostly on a remote.
Suspected noise identified. Beginning security patrol. Security alert.
I saw a door to this building. Chest. Down in this building. Thank you.
grows. Performing an area sweep now. Thank you. sissy, isn't it? Oh, this inventing.
Hey, Phantom! You're not real. You're not real. Not real. real. You're not real. Just leave me alone. You're not real. You're not real. Go away, Phantom. Leave me alone! You're not real. 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 Get away from me, Phantom. Shoot. Scram. You can talk? The Phantom's never talked before. I knew I shouldn't have eaten that sprat raw. See? See, Higgins? This is why you must always boil your sprats before ingesting.
Higgins, the Phantom's got a name?
No, you can't possibly be a hallucination. You're much too dense. Not at all, my corporeal friend. Higgins is my name. Chester D. Higgins. The D stands for definitely not insane. I use it as a reminder. Higgins has been many things over the years. Sprat Wrangler, Saltuna Critic, Aetherwave Personality, Chairman of the Board, Galactic Defender, Sisty Pig Tycoon. I've come a long way for someone who started off as a simple engineer right here in this plant.
You were an engineer.
I specialized in automechanicals, drones, sentries. Repaired them, maintained, upgraded. Did it all from my old workroom just over in the next section.
Look,
I don't want to fall into any trouble with the mechanicals. If they wise up to our plans, they will come for us with prodding irons.
Good point.
Uh-huh. So, you see my dilemma. Funny thing. I was working on a logic module just before the mayhem started. Security chief found me and confiscated the logic module. The tail. Definitely start with the tail. If you're feeling adventurous, the ears are a particular delicacy. Mechanicals lost their bolts. Opened fire on anything that moved. It was pandemonium. You mean why did the mechanicals go on a murderous rampage? Same reason any of us do, I suppose. The voices told them to do it. I was on cleaning duty at the time. My old boss had me scrubbing pipes when the killing started. So, as usual, I missed out. Jimmy'd opened the vending machines. That lasted a good couple of months. Eventually, I had to resort to more unconventional means of filling my insides. Braised, boiled, charred, skewered. Sprats are good eating, friend. Chock full of brain food. I specialized in automechanicals, drones, sentries. Repaired them, maintained, upgraded. Did it all from my old workroom just over in the next section. Jimmy'd opened the vending machines. That lasted a good couple of months. Eventually, I had to resort to more unconventional means of filling my insides.
I don't know what I'm doing.
Unexpected. Processing.
That would be nice to have. I got what I came here for. Oh shit, did I get lost? Kinda.
Bring us honor, soldier. Bang up work, soldier. You're a credit to your uniform.
Oh, that reminds me. Gotta look into getting us a uniform.
So this is it, then. The key to humanity's victory over the mechanical hordes. I would reward you with the gratitude of the resistance, but I'm guessing you want something tactile. So here's a couple bits for your trouble, and a little something to remember me by.
What would you do for a conduct bar?
Something got you down?
Nothing. Just don't want to cross. Almost lost a finger in the cannery today.
At least you got your health.
If people look at me funny, that's just because they don't hear you like I do. Hold on. Just a... There's a ting-ting kashik noise. Repeats every 6 seconds. One of the e-motor pinions stripped a gear. I just spent 2 days realigning the magnetic drivers, now this. If I don't replace it, it'll bust in... sounds like 96 hours? Maybe 97? Mr. Thompson's gonna be mad at me again. Either because I take the time to fix it now, or because it breaks again later. I fix busted stuff. I got wrenches over there, diagnostics yonder, a big power lift in the floor. Oh, I could show you the pneumatic press, if you want. Sometimes I use it to smoosh cans of Saltuna. Don't tell Mr. Thompson. Aside from keeping the cannery running, I fix most anything that's got busted. Loaders, computers, doors. One time, I got to work on a freighter with a bad thruster block.
Yeah, it's very...
Only with every part of my body! Is that rude? We don't leave town much anymore. When I was little, I used to wander all over. You know, wild canids and marauder gangs, lava flows and crashing ships. We should be fine together, though.
Okay. At least they give him a reason to have a party.
Hey, mister, can we talk? This is where the magic happens. Well, science. But it still happens. Where are we headed? Something you need?
She's back.
Where are we headed?
Yeah, that's a good question. Where are we headed?
Move along, stranger. We don't want any trouble.
You saying it. Blend right in.
I don't know you. Whatever you're looking for, it ain't here. Move along. I'm strangers wandering into my camp for one. Some of my camp wandering out for another. Got anything in you besides questions? No, I'm sorry. That was unworthy of me. Lady named Zoe went missing some nights ago. Just up and vanished without a trace. Now I'm pacing around wondering if marauders got to her. Not like Zoe to go wandering. Figured she might be out scavenging, but that ain't exactly her talent. Can't imagine where she's gone. Vale's a wide place. She could be anywhere. Could do without the gallows humor. Over in the hothouse, tending crop. I'll tell you what I can. Vex me. If she told anybody, they ain't telling me. I'd check her room, but I got yelled at for snooping once already. Little ways ago, she was always obsessing over her serial dramas. Wanted to see what the fuss was about. Well, enough to know we never got on. Zoe and Stefan were close. If anybody knows the workings of her mind, he does. She was lazy and thoughtless, but she's still one of our own. Could be. Dangers are plenty out there. No telling why marauders would steal somebody like Zoe. Got no useful skill as far as I can tell. Marauder gang just moved into the districts a little ways east. Their numbers are growing. Gotta come from somewhere. What is it?
Let's stop it here. Thanks for viewing. See y'all next time.